Welcome back to my channel. Now, if you're new with us or you don't know who I am, hi, my name is Katie. On this channel, we cover video production tips, product reviews, tutorials, vlogs, and much more. Now, if you're into any of that stuff, I would appreciate it if you hit that subscribe button. It really helps me out, and hopefully it helps you guys out as well. Let's get right into the topic for today. So the first thing that you're going to have to decide on is the content of your video. What's it going to be about? What's the theme going to be? What are you going to be filming? These are important questions to ask, but don't get stuck on these questions. Oftentimes I talk to people who want to be filmmakers and they're stuck on the ideas. They think that their life isn't interesting. They think that the topics that are going on in their head aren't interesting. They think that they aren't an interesting person. You can make a video about anything. In fact, you can also make a video about nothing. I can't tell you how many videos I've made about absolutely nothing. So for the purposes of this video, we're just gonna film something. Now for the example video that I made for the purposes of this video, I just shot outside. I shot some cool shots in the morning a couple days ago. I shot some of the chickens and the hen house, and that was the video. So don't let that stop you from making a video. All right, so now we are actually picking up our phone, and the first thing that I always notice, low light, when there's not enough light coming into the lens in the space or environment that you're filming in. So if you were filming in a dark room and everything's grainy and like blurry, that's because you don't have enough light coming into the lens. So the easiest thing that you can do right now for making this video is going outside into the sunny, bright backyard, unless you don't have a backyard and then you would be violating quarantine rules. Please don't do that. Thanks. The other thing that you can do is record next to a window. If you actually have lighting options, like some lamps or some flashlights or things like that, make that area bright. And you're gonna see the quality of your videos change in a positive way just by adding a little bit more light to the environment that you're filming in. Oftentimes what happens, or what's missed at the very beginning of making a video, is interest to the shot. When I was younger and was starting to make films, I would just kind of point and shoot, and I wouldn't really think about the angle or the interest of the shot. So for the purpose of this video, what I want you to do is I want you to take your phone and put an object right next to the lens, or fairly close to the lens, as close as it can be to actually focus. You'll see it automatically focus on that object. And then I want you to make sure that you can also see the background within that shot. Now look how interesting it is. The object itself may not be interesting, but the shot is interesting because you have something that's really in focus, and then you have the background that's super, super blurry. Think about these sorts of shots when filming your first video, because these are just naturally interesting shots. When you have some depth and some interest to the shot, you've got something in focus, you've got things out of focus, that is already going to be a winner for an interesting shot. So those are the two main things to think about when filming. Now, from there, let's move on to our editing process. You've filmed all of your shots, you've got some cool, interesting shots going on, you're excited. Now you're gonna throw them into your editing software. And this is where things get a little intimidating. I remember the first time I started editing in an actual video editor, and I was scared because I was like, I don't know where to start. That's okay. Take your time. If you don't know how to import something, Google it. Also, just play with it. You're not gonna mess anything up by hitting some buttons and playing with some footage. Now, for the purposes of this video, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time showing you exactly how to do specific things in iMovie because we're gonna keep this really, really basic. You're gonna import your footage into your editing software, and then you're gonna put it into your timeline. Now, I would recommend to start off just putting one clip in at a time. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna help you focus on just that shot for a little bit until you move the next one in after that. Also, something that can save you a lot of time is thinking about each shot in succession. So like, what do you want your first shot to be? What do you want your last shot to be? So I put my first clip in and then I clip it. What that means is I'm just cutting it. I'm making it smaller. I'm taking one specific part of the shot and only keeping that piece of the footage. So you can do that by hovering over the ends of those pieces of footage. This applies to most editing programs. And then you can actually drag it to the right or left, or you can hover over the area of the clip that you want to cut and you can right click and hit cut. Now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to figure out where we want different kinds of transitions. I really don't like seeing wipe or grid transitions, so things that aren't a fade or a crossover. Fades and crossovers are great transitions because they're universal across a lot of different editing softwares. You want to keep it as simple as possible. A plain cut without any transition can work really, really well, and it doesn't distract the viewer from what's happening in the video. Now we're going to talk really quickly about some actual camera transitions that you can do that work really, really well. Things like pans, tilts, and the whip shot. You start in one position and then you really quickly move to another position. That's a whip shot. Now we're gonna be talking about specifically how to make this work well and how to use it in your timeline, in your video sequence. First, let's cover some of the more basic ones like the tilt and the pans. Any kind of movement that you add to your camera is going to create shake. So here are some tips to help you keep your footage a little bit more stable naturally. First of all, your stance needs to be right. So you need to spread those legs out a little bit, keep your feet a little bit further away from each other. And when you're in a little bit wider stance, you add more stability to the core, to your main frame of your body. And this is gonna help even with your arms positioning out, holding your camera. And something else that I found that helps is keeping your elbows close to your body. So not bringing and extending your arms all the way out, bringing them in, and holding your camera as close to your body as possible. Also, if you're doing things like pans or tilts, try to do them as much with the center of your body, not with your hands and arms. So move your entire body when you're panning, move your entire body when you're tilting up and down. Now let's talk about this whip shot really quickly. I actually use it a couple times in my video. Keep some consistency between your previous shot and the shot coming up. So obviously you could see in the previous shot, there was some of the foreground and background that was consistent with my whip shot. And then at the video after that transitional whip shot, there was some consistency, including the chickens, the pen, those sorts of things. It doesn't have to be the same positioning. In fact, it shouldn't be the same, but it should be at least the same object or same kind of environment that you're in the transitional whip shot. They're great transitions to have. Don't use them too much. The audience picks up consistency really, really fast, and it will lose all interest if the audience feels like you're using that whip shot too much or in places where it doesn't feel like it needs it. So finally, we've edited all of our videos. We have everything cut the way we want it. Now we need to add some cool music. And we're gonna go to YouTube's audio library and we're gonna pick a track from there. They have a lot of different themes, a lot of different moods, a lot of different styles of music, including rock, classical, jazz, cinematic, lots of different things out there. So you're definitely gonna be able to find something. They also have a sound effects panel as well. I didn't use any canned sound effects for this video. I just used the recorded audio for each track. And then I overlaid some natural birds and background of a shot that I recorded for a longer amount of time under the bottom of each of those videos. So that's your video, and we've just gone from the beginning to the end of this video project, and here you have this great video. Hopefully you have something that you're proud of, and if you don't, just keep on working at it. These are basic tips and tricks that are going to apply to you for a long time. These are things that I apply to my video editing and my cinematic shooting principles even now as a little bit more of an intermediate filmmaker. So that brings us to the end of this video. So if you liked this video or you felt like it was helpful, definitely hit that like button. Also, if you wanna see more content like this, definitely comment below, let me know that you like this video and you wanna see more. Also hit that subscribe button to see more of my content. And finally, hit that little notification bell because that will notify you every time I have a video that comes out. I come out with a video at least twice a week, so you don't want to miss any of those cool videos that come out. Hope that you have a fantastic day, and I will see you on the next video.